Hey guys, Adam here, and welcome to another installment of The Ways. So we just finished a 2-minute warm-up, a little stretch, and now we're getting into another great warm-up, which is wall balls. It's a great way to prime the body for squats, to get the whole body warmed up, to learn coordination, rhythm, and technique. And they're not easy to do. You know, the main thing is to sit in that deep squat, catch it on the way down, and pop it up with the whole body. Okay, so into the muscle snatch now. So while I'm doing these, Amanda was doing dumbbell clean and press. So the muscle snatch is a great lift. It's a great standalone lift to build explosive strength and power. It's also a great accessory lift for the power snatch or the full snatch to help you learn that third pull. Now the objective here is to keep the bar as close to your body as possible without touching your body if possible and not dropping the elbow under. Okay, it's not a wide grip clean and press. It's a snatch movement. So you want to pull the bar all the way through. Okay, so I finished off that last set of muscle snatch with 155 for a double, and I thought that was pretty good for that session. And now we're getting into the core exercises. Hitting some Roman chair as a warm-up. Just doing a couple sets of 12. And then we'll get into some medicine ball combinations with the Roman chairs with throwing the med ball.
Alright, so 12 of those. Then we'll grab a small med ball for a few sets. Come all the way up. Be dynamic too. Slow down and up fast. Power up. There you go. Use that core to lift you. Good. Excellent. Do 12. Two more. Excellent. Good now, eh?
Okay, so now we're getting into some medicine ball throws from the Roman chair. Throwers are, you know, by far the strongest athletes for, you know, one big reason. They have to generate a lot of force and a lot of power to throw things far. So if you're going to incorporate any kind of throwing movements into your workout, you should definitely do that. So we're throwing this ball back and forth. This is a 7-pound wall ball or medicine ball. And then we go up to a 9-pound and then a 13-pound medicine ball, I believe. So three cycles of this back and forth, and it's a great burn.
Good. See what you can do. That's it. Good. You say when. Awesome. Look at that. Rockstar.
Okay.
Good? Excellent.
Okay, so now we're getting into something that I've done for years and years, plyometrics. Great for making you an all-around better athlete, explosiveness, it's going to help you with your squat, and that's why it's so important to do full squats and pause squats because they go hand in hand. Main thing is to start on a low box and work on that soft landing and not having your knees cave in. And Amanda has been improving greatly with these. She hates them, but I make her do them because they're such a great thing to add into your workout. So it's a 20-inch box for her, and we did four sets of six. And you see by the end that her stance, her landing was already getting better, more stable. And this is a 24-inch box for me, which is pretty low. It's just a matter of getting the reps in. Again, working on that soft landing. And so work those in. It's just a great thing to add to your program. Now, some of you feel that the treadmill, elliptical, the bike, Stairmaster are overrated for cardio as I do. And you want to try something fun and build functional strength at the same time, give Med Ball Slams a try. They're just a great addition to your workout. And 20 minutes of these, you know, is more beneficial than an hour or more on a treadmill. So what you're trying to do here is you're trying to generate force straight from your toes, high over your head, and using your core to slam that ball into the ground as hard as you can. It takes a lot of coordination. And Amanda's stance here is a little wide, and you know, she'll get the coordination, but she is still getting the core benefit. She's still getting the functional strength benefit and a great cardio workout. So add these into your program and you won't be sorry. Be careful though, you're trying to throw that ball as close to your feet to create as straight a path as possible. But as funny as it is to see, if you smack yourself in the face, it's going to hurt like hell. So just be careful when you're doing it. And just to note that I'm using the 20-pound medicine ball and Amanda is using the 15-pound for her last set. And the last thing on our medicine ball circuit are side throws. Another great exercise. There's so much you can do with medicine balls that, you know, I like to see people use them more often. It's a real old school way of doing things. Sometimes, you know, old school is best. And so, again, you're trying to use your core to throw the ball, not so much your arms. You want to keep your arms straight as possible. And make sure you get both sides. So we finished off our plyo part of the workout with some standing long jumps. Another great way to build explosive strength. And you want to, again, have a soft landing and really nail that landing. So you see it's been a while since I've done them myself. I'm a little rusty. But the more we do these, the better we're going to get at them. And we finished off the day with hyperextensions, just body weight hypers. We do these with weight, but it's just a great way to get a stretch at the end of the workout, especially in your low back. And if you put the pad down a little past that hinge in your pelvis there, you're going to get more hamstring and more glute involvement. So it's just a great finisher. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you have any questions, hit me up in the comments section. And as always, please like and subscribe.